you can see, I found a couple of things so far. Busy today. It's actually been a long time since I've gone this way to get over to Best Buy. So, yeah. I know it's been a couple weeks since I haven't done an episode, but, you know, weather and also just the fact that there hasn't really been a whole lot for me to come out here to get. So that's why I haven't been really doing anything, but I have been putting videos up in place. But let's go on to Best Buy. We're only a couple months away from them not having physical media anymore. When I checked online for this particular store, they said they still have them in there. So we're going to check inside and see what they got. I'm not expecting a whole lot in there, honestly, but I have a gift card from my birthday that I have to use, so might not really have to use it now. I could probably use it on something else later on, but might as well use it on the last bit of physical media they have left in here. So, yeah. Let's go inside and see what they got. You also might be noticing RVs all over the place. That's why. I guess when they're not doing the vegetable thing, the food and vegetable thing that they do during the summertime, they have RVs. Neat. Well, it's still here, but as you can see, the new release thing is gone, so slowly but surely, it's all going away. I don't know if I'm, like I said, I don't know if I'm going to find anything in particular. I'm just going to see what they have. We still got some Black Panther steelbooks here for $15. And we also have a Fast X steelbook. Is that $15 too? I think. I don't know. Will today be the day? Let's see. Let's see what else they got. There's another really good deal. Ninja Turtles on 4K for $11.99. This is the Michael Bay one. Do I really need to double dip on it? Probably not, but $12 is too good of a deal to pass up on. So that's another one I might pick up. Let's see what else we got here. This one here is not that great of a deal, but $10 for Jackie Brown. I wanted to get this one for a while too, so putting it in the pile. Creed 3 is $15. Shazam's $15, the steelbook for that. Meg 2 The Trench is only $15. I have the Walmart steelbook version, so. But $15 though, that's tempting. Let me go ahead and think about it. Put it in the pile. Not that one. Yeah. It's a random one. Atlantic City. This is like one of those Walmart... Not Walmart. Amazon exclusive ones. Because, like, you don't have the Blu-ray thing on top there. Rudy here, but it's still $32. I don't know why. I don't know if it's just specific ones that are going down in price, but that one I feel like should be going down in price too. But maybe it's just the ones they've had for a while now, because this one's still fairly new. That's what I like to get, but not for $32. I'm just gonna see if they still have the 4K stand here, but it looks like they do not. So all the movies were over in that one section there. Got a decent selection here. I don't know if I'm gonna get them all yet, but at least there was something. Subway. So what exactly did I get from Subway? They have the new Subway Sidekick stuff. They have a foot-long churro. I think this is for $2. A foot-long pretzel for $3, which is an Auntie Anne's pretzel. It's a Cinnabon churro. And then a foot-long cookie for, I think, $5, if I'm not mistaken, which I found out, surprisingly, the footlong cookie actually has more calories than the footlong pretzel, which is hard to believe. So what exactly did I grab there? So let me go ahead and show you what I got. And I got the footlong pretzel, which for $3 is an amazing price, especially when you consider that Auntie Anne's pretzels over there are actually much more expensive. I think a pretzel is like $8 or something, so you could buy two of these for that price. But I'm assuming I've never had Subway before. I assume it's gonna taste like an Auntie Anne's pretzel, but I will let you know in just a second. Definitely does taste like an Auntie Anne's pretzel, but more toasted, because they put it in their toaster oven at Subway. It definitely feels very different, but it's also kind of feels like the same kind of a pretzel you'd get at Auntie Anne's. But this is the interesting thing, too, about this. See, look right here. $3 for the pretzel, $2.69 for a drink, which I got. I only paid $6 for that. It's like I said, you could buy 2-foot-long pretzels at Subway for the same price as a regular pretzel over at Auntie Anne's. But that's just amazing to think about. So that foot-long pretzel was actually pretty good. I wish it was a little bit hotter, but, you know, $3, man, that's a pretty good deal for stuff, and that's pretty good. I thought about getting that foot-long cookie that they had for $5, but I'm going to wait till next week to get that. But I wanted to try that out, so on to the next stop. And that next stop for the day is, of course, Barnes & Noble. It's been a while since I've been in here. Let's see if they got anything new. Well, we're actually off to a good start. Arrow titles are 50% off. And I'm already seeing one I want to get my hands on. Witness. Great Harrison Ford movie directed by Peter Weir. So that'd be $25. So that's something I'm going to pick up. We got Conan the Destroyer and Conan the Barbarian here as well for $30 after the discount. Let's see what else they got. We got Paramount titles for 50% off too. Let's see what they got. Steve McQueen, John Wayne, Braveheart, Annihilation, great movie. True Grit, Dragon Slayer, Dungeons and Dragons. That's actually a pretty good deal considering that movie only came out less than a year ago. Once Upon a Time in the West, Escape from Alcatraz, Island in the Sky, Transformers, Ninja Turtles. That John Wayne set's actually pretty cool. I have it already, but 50% off of 80, that's $40 for 14 movies. It's actually not a bad deal. Lost City, Big Jake, Dead Reckoning Part 1. I'm sorry, Dead Reckoning now. They just made that. This is no longer a two-part movie. Top Gun Maverick, original Top Gun, all the Indiana Jones movies, except for the new one. Sonic 2, Jim Carrey's coming back for the third one, which I kind of figured was going to happen, but they just announced it yesterday. Paw Patrol, Under the Boardwalk, just came out recently. That's not bad for $9. Charlotte's Web. Really underrated movie, honestly. Greatest Show on Earth, which actually won Best Picture back in the 1950s. 52. Adam's Family, Night at the Roxbury, Pretty in Pink, Audrey Hepburn Collection. Again, not a bad deal on that. $27 originally. It's about $14 for 7 movies. Paper Moon, Almost Famous. Great movie, Last Holiday. Not a great movie, Norbit. Cary Grant. Warriors, Collateral, McClintock, Hunt for Red October. Ten Commandments, True Grit, Godfather. Clue, Airplane. School of Rock, Confess Fletch. Mean Girls on Steelbook, the original. Popeye. Great deal on that. Nacho Libre, She's the Man, The Godfather Series, Saturday Night Fever, Footloose, Flashdance, Days of Thunder, Jerry Lewis Collection, how much is that? Not a bad deal, 10 movies for $13, that's actually really good. So if you're looking for some movies there you go. Alfred Hitchcock, is there anything else down here? Ghost in the Darkness, Chinatown, Rosemary's Baby, the 4K. That's a good deal too. That's only about $15 after the discount. Hellraiser, Fatal Attraction, Quiet Place, Smile, Halloween, Ten Commandments. So they do have some good deals here. Pulp Fiction, Godfather, Sliver. So a lot of really good deals going on here. I have most of these already, but if you're looking for some Paramount titles, go to your Barnes & Noble. new Criterion title that came out this week, Trainspotting. This is the 4K version. It's really nice, like an envelope. For $49.99. Again, I'll wait for the Barnes & Noble sale to take shape to get that. It's a regular Blu-ray. Great movie. Gotta wait for Pinocchio 2. Here's probably the biggest new release of the last couple of weeks, Trolls Band Together. So 30% off of 40, so be about, I think 25 maybe? 25, 30? I'm not gonna spend that much on that to complete the collection. I'll just wait for that to come down in price. On to our next stop for the day, Half Price Books. Let's go inside and see what they got. Well, it took me a while, but I am finding some stuff now. I got the Rogue Nation Steelbook. Shout Factory Misery for $12.49. That's tempting. And I look up here. This really cool Lady and the Tramp Digibook from Target. Again, might be an option too. So it took a while. Like I said, it took a while, but I am finding some stuff now. Logan. I'm gonna keep looking. Check that up out there. Only $12.49. That's actually a really good deal. I'm over here by like the older antique books and all that. Check this out. Bob Hope specials. $50. But look inside of here. You get a book. You get a magazine. But you also get all the different Bob Hope specials he did. He did a lot of specials back in the day for NBC. There was like one, two, three, four sets in here. That's a four-disc set. Four, that's eight. That's 12. That's a one-disc. I think this one here, this last one down here, is an eight-disc, too. Six-disc. So let's see. Six. That's eight. That's 14, 15, 19 discs for $50 plus the magazine. I don't know, that's pretty tempting. $50 though. Maybe if I didn't buy a whole lot of stuff today, I'd probably pick it up, but I don't know. I think I'm going to hold off for now, but that's something I'm definitely tempted to pick up. Plus, it's been here for a couple of years, so maybe, just maybe, it'll stick around for a little bit more, but yeah, this is something I'm definitely interested in possibly picking up. Not today, but maybe one day. So did Linda's sister Gail put green light these books? This feels like something out of Bob's Burgers. Alrighty guys, I am 3 for 3 today. 3 places, 3 purchases, and the day is still young. As you can tell, it is sunny out, it's nice, and as you can see, I don't need to wear my jacket anymore. My sweatshirt, at least for right now. But, I don't know. Like, pretty good day so far overall. But, we're going to head over to McDonald's because they actually have something there that I actually am very curious about. I just saw it on the sign. It's just like, that's interesting. So let's go see what they have. There it is right there. The double Big Mac. I think I'm going to go grab that. So you got four patties in here. It kind of looks like, I mean, it literally looks like a double quarter pounder, but, I don't know, I'm curious. It's probably not going to taste any different. More than likely, it's not going to taste any different, but we'll see. Well, that was kind of a letdown. I mean, it's a good burger and all, but honestly, it's basically just the double quarter pounder, except instead of putting the two quarter pound burgers, it's four regular McDonald's burgers. I mean, it's literally nothing different. I mean, I even took some video after I ate to see the menu to see what the prices were. The double Big Mac menu, the large meal is like $11.79. Meanwhile, the quarter pounder meal is $11.39. So I'm paying 40 extra cents for four Big Mac patties instead of the two quarter pounder patties. I mean, I don't think it's a good deal, but what do I know? But, you know, it's experiment. You know, experimenting it, trying it out, didn't work out in my favor, and I kind of regret it. But at the same time, I mean, yeah, if you try it once, you probably never do it again. I mean, if I did it again, I'd probably just get the double quarter pounder. But then again, when it comes to me and hamburgers, I'm usually very, like, picky with... I'm a very picky eater. I freely admit to being that. So when it comes to hamburgers, I usually just like my hamburgers plain with nothing on it, just the burger and the bun. So I don't know. Maybe it's because of me. I'm blaming myself for this. But like I said, it's an experiment. Like, I'm probably never going to get it again. But try it once, never try it again. So anyway, destination... I haven't been inside Ollie's in a while. We'll see if they got anything. I doubt it, but we'll see. And that is why we don't go into Ollie's often, because they don't usually have anything in there that I really need or I could sell online or anything like that. Most of the time, it's just the same stuff they've had for the last, 7 years since they've been open? Like, they used to have movies all the time here, and then they got rid of those. And they used to have, like, special blowouts, like, special stuff that they could... is that they got to sell, and, like, they don't have those anymore. Like, it's really... I don't know. I don't like going into Ollie's very often. I never really liked going into Ollie's, even when we had it down in Westmoreland, down there before this place opened up. There's just nothing in there of interest for me. There's just nothing in there that makes me say, I have to get this. I have to buy this. And it's just like... I don't know. Like, to me, like, Ollie's is not worth it to me. So... anyway, let's go ahead and, go somewhere else. We still got a little bit of time left, but not too much time, so let's keep going. Alright, time to head to the movie theater to see Argyle. Okay, so we're back home now after a very long day. It was a very long day of doing stuff. I'll show you everything I picked up at the mall and also some other places I went to after I went to go see the movie. But I want to show you the stuff that I found at the thrift store that I went to early in the morning to start the video off. So... most of this stuff is stuff I'm going to sell online. I found this old Sesame Street record from 1976, Mad / Sad, featuring Little Jimmy and the Monotones. Got all the characters from Sesame Street there. This is only like 50 cents, so I'm sure I can make a profit off of that. And a whole stack of DVDs. This one I'm keeping. This is one I found that... I've been wanting to get it for a while now, and I found it there. Figured why not get this for myself. Sledgehammer, the complete series. Kind of before the Naked Gun movies and just after Police Squad, they had this show on ABC back in the 80s. It's one I've been looking for on DVD for a while now, and I found it there for like $2, so that's going to be added to my collection. And then everything else here is stuff I'm selling. I found a new copy of Charlie's Angels Season 1. Still brand new, factory sealed.
Black Sheep's brand new back, factory sealed. Dodgeball factory sealed. Everybody Loves Raymond, the series finale. This one is open, but I think I can get something for that. This was probably the best find that I saw. Don Knotts, the four-movie collection, still wrapped up in the packaging. So you get the Apple Dumpling Gang movies, Hot Lead and Cold Feet, and also Gus. And like I said, brand new, never opened. Sure can make a profit off of that. Both of the Avengers, the Emma Peel episodes, Volumes 1 and Volume 2. Paranormal Activity, the three-movie collection on DVD. All three movies in there. And then last of the DVDs, the Oprah Winfrey 20th Anniversary Collection. All these were $2. I should be able to make more than that on those. And then last but not least over here, you saw that this in the store. Only you can prevent forest fires. Smokey the Bear. He's got his shovel, which is a little bit... the wood's a little off there, but... I mean, it still should be good, but... you can see that he's not wearing any pants, and Smokey should be wearing pants. I did not know this until after I purchased it, but... you know what? He's Smokey the Bear. He can do whatever he wants. I mean, that guy is, I mean, he's trying to protect the forest. I mean, he can do whatever he wants. He's trying to protect you from wildfires, but, yeah, for $6, I should be able to get something more than this. I saw this online going for, like, $40 for the whole set inside the packaging and with pants, so... if I can make $20 off of this, I'll be good. So, those are all the pickups from the thrift store, and let me go ahead and show you some of the stuff I picked up today. So, from Half Price Books, I did grab this Reservoir Dogs set, which is a really cool-looking set. Not only do you get the movie on Blu-ray, which I already have, but I bought the Steelbook for it a couple years ago, but you get these 6 shot glasses, and these were only $12.49, and I gotta figure I can maybe get something for this. This is a really nice-looking set. I should be able to get more than that, but like I said, man, this is a really cool set, and even if I don't sell, I probably would keep this for myself, but... this is a really nice-looking set. Who made this? Premium Concepts and Designs, Inc. So, yeah, that's pretty cool. For $13, I should be able to get something for that. Some of the stuff I didn't get to show you, I got the soundtrack to Midnight in Paris, which is my favorite Woody Allen movie, one of my favorite movies of all time. $5 for this. I didn't have a copy of it. And I like the music in it, so I picked that up. And then, of course, I grabbed the Lady and the Tramp digibook for $10. Really nice-looking set. One of my favorite Disney movies. And then, of course, I had to grab Misery. This is the one I actually don't have a copy of, and I really don't understand why I don't. But, hey, Scream Factory, Shout Factory, gotta pick it up. For $12.49, I couldn't pass that up. And everything was 10% off, too, because I had coupons. So, overall, I only paid about... $40 in general for all of this at Half Price Book, which was not bad at all. So next up from Barnes & Noble, the first of 2 Barnes & Nobles I went to. I'll talk about that in just a second. I did grab Witness. I grabbed the Arrow version of this. $25 after the discount, the 50% discount. Which I found out this is not, they don't take 10% off on the extra Arrow titles. They did on everything else I bought at Barnes & Noble, at least the one in Monroeville, but... I did not have a copy of this movie on any version, I don't think. I don't think I have it on DVD, but if I'm going to get a version of it, I might as well get this nice-looking Blu-ray version of it. Arrow usually puts out really cool-looking sets, as we're going to show you just a little bit, but... classic Harrison Ford movie. Peter Weir directed it. Really looking forward to watching that one again. I did grab these as well. I just kind of saw them both there. I've been looking at them for the last couple weeks. I figured, why not get them today? The complete script for Oppenheimer, which is $18, and then the complete script of Barbie, which was $20. You know, it's Barbenheimer time, baby. Barbenheimer season. So I grabbed both of those. Really nice looking books. I like this design of this cover, by the way. Gold with the pink in there. And then, of course, Cillian Murphy looking at the bomb going off on that one. Two of my favorite movies from last year. Had to get the books for these. So that's what I got from the first Barnes & Noble. And I'll show you what I got from Barnes & Noble 2 in just a second. And then again, pretty much everything you saw at Best Buy. Meg 2 The Trench. I got that for $15. The Steelbook. Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles for $12. Jackie Brown for $10. And Fast X The Steelbook for $15. So pretty packed day for the most part. And we're not done just yet. Because after I got done at the movie theater, I actually ran down to another Barnes & Noble down at the Waterworks. We had somewhere to go before then. So they wanted to run into. I ran into Barnes & Noble. So I went into Barnes & Noble and in the Waterworks, and I found a ton more stuff there that they did not have in Monroeville. So I picked that. So I'll show you some of the things I picked up here. And then really, I saved a lot of money on the stuff that I have right here. So, first off, some more Arrow titles. A Blu-ray copy of The Warriors. They only had the 4K version over in Monroeville. And for $25, didn't have a copy of this physically, so grab that. So, Warriors. This is probably one of the better deals I found today. Both the Conan movies on Arrow Video for $40. This was originally $80. And it was $40. They had the regular sets for $30 after the 50% off. So I could have gotten both of those, but $40 for this is not a bad deal for this whatsoever. I've actually never seen these in full. I've only seen them in little bits and pieces, and they look pretty silly. But it's Arnold, man. You gotta love it for Arnold, man. And if you don't, then to hell with you. I apologize for the terrible Arnold impersonation. But last but not least, this was probably the best deal I found today. So I found this. And this is something I've been wanting to get for a while now, but I've been waiting for the price to come down on it. I finally found it in person. Star Trek Strange New Worlds Season 2, the Steelbook. Now, this was not $58. When I looked online at Barnes & Noble's website, I thought I was going to pay $46 for it. And I thought, you know what? It's a little bit too it's still a little bit expensive, but this is my first time seeing this anywhere, and I just have to leap on it because I'm probably not going to see this anywhere else unless I go online and get it. So I took it up to the register, and it actually turned out to be much cheaper than that. You know what the price on this was? For a steelbook copy of this, I have it right here, $28.99. This was actually 50% off, and I'm glad that I took that chance because, man, $29 for this on steelbook is really impressive, and I don't think you can get the regular version for that low of a price. I mean, that's how crazy the price was on this. That $28.99 for this on Steelbook. Just, that's probably my favorite purchase of the day because I've been looking for this for a long time. When it was on Amazon, it's still on Amazon for, I think, $46. And I only paid $29 for this. So, and the strange thing about this one is that this one also didn't come off of my... They didn't take 10% off of my membership for this. I don't know if they're not just including Blu-rays in general or because it was already 50% off. I don't know. But like I said, I'll take it, man, because $29 for this, a brand new Steelbook version of this, that's the best deal I got today, easily. Conan's probably the second one, but yeah. I'm glad with that purchase. And I do have one more thing that I got in the mail this week from Walmart. This is something that it's a Walmart exclusive. Been waiting to get it for a while now. I pre-ordered it back in October, and it kept getting delayed, and it finally came this week. Walk Hard, the Dewey Cox story, this nice-looking steelbook set. John C. Reilly, fantastic in this movie. This movie should have been the wake-up call for everybody to stop doing the same damn music biopic over and over again. But unfortunately, it's continued to be that same way for the last couple of years, but this is really one of the best underrated comedies you'll ever see. If you haven't seen this movie, definitely seek this one out because it's really funny, really well done, produced by Judd Apatow, written by him as well, I think. And John C. Reilly's just fantastic in this movie. This movie deserves a lot more attention than it gets, and this has a nice-looking steelbook for it. I highly recommend checking out Walk Hard if you haven't seen it already. So, yeah. Busy day. We got a lot of stuff. I saw Argyle, which tomorrow's review is going to be fun for that one. And I might actually record it tonight, but I'm not entirely sure just yet. But I have a lot to say because four movies now in the first 5 weeks of the year that are automatically going to be in my worst of the year list. That's a new record for the first 5 weeks of the year, which is pretty impressive. I'm going to try to watch one of the movies. I'm really looking forward to checking out DreamWorks' Orion in the Dark on Netflix. Looking forward to checking that out at some point later tonight. But it's been a long day. Thank you for watching this. This has been another episode of Movie Stop. It's been a long time since I've done one of these, it feels like. It's only been a couple weeks, but it feels like more than that. But I'm glad I found a ton of stuff today. I did pretty well in most of the places I went to. There were a couple of places that weren't really successful and all that, but most of what I did worked out very well. I think I did pretty well today. So like I said, thank you so much for watching. And if you want to see more videos like this, like I said, hit the like and subscribe button. Check out the last episode I did, and I will see you guys next time. So thank you for watching. I'll see you next time. And until then, take care.